So in this whole video, I'm going to show you how to work with your extensions. I'm also going to show you why we might want to do that, as well as work with other things such as our apps, and I'll have some other news there towards the end. Now, to remove an extension, all you have to do is take your mouse and go up to the very top there. If you look at the top right-hand corner, there's a puzzle piece. Now, it may look like an ink block or something like that, but basically it's just a puzzle piece. And if you float your mouse over it, it does say extensions. So go ahead and click that, as I have done there. And then once you've done that, it'll come up and you'll have the list of pinned extensions. Now, these are the extensions that you actually see at the very top there. And it gives you options to unpin them, that is, remove them from the area up there. But if you notice, there's three little dots next to them. Just go ahead and let's click on one of those there. And boom, you have the option to remove it. Now, the reason why we would want to remove it in the first place is because maybe it's an extension that is changing our home screen, or it's changing our search engine, or it's doing some other thing there that we really don't like. And many people may even call that malware, you know, or something like that. Basically a malicious software that does something that you really don't want it to do, right? One good example of that was an app called, or an extension called WeatherBug. And what it would do is it would change your search engine, it would change your homepage and do other things to you. It was really nasty there because it did that, and people were just removing it left and right. All right, let's go in. Let's just say that you don't see the name of the extension that you want there, or maybe you want to see a more complete list. If you look at the very bottom of this, it says manage extensions. Click on manage extensions, and there you go. You have a complete list there. And notice that they have two little buttons on them. One says details, the other says remove. Well, maybe you want to know what permissions you're giving each extension. So all you got to do is just click on details. And when you do, another page opens up, and notice that it does give you the details of what that extension is doing there. And you can actually control more options within that extension. So it really does give you a bit of leeway there of how you control what it does. Let's go back here. And if you were to click on remove, let's say that I wanted to click on remove on one of these. So you just click on remove, and notice it gives you the option there. Do you want to remove this from Chrome? And you can click on remove there, and it will remove it from your Chrome browser. Now, these steps are, they work the same whether you're working within a Windows machine, a Macintosh, or a Chromebook, or something else. And that's kind of nice because I just make one video for everyone there. Now, let's just say that for some reason you don't see the puzzle piece up there. Maybe you have a different version of the Chrome OS or Chrome browser, and you just don't see the extension there. All you have to do is click on the three dots. That's called the Customize Control Google Chrome. And when you click on there, you should see a menu pop down. Once that menu pops down, go to More Tools, and then Extensions. So you can click on Extensions from right there, and then that will take you to the exact same spot that we've been talking about. So now you know two ways to find extensions, which is kind of nice there. Hey, by the way, this is SelmaTeacher7's YouTube channel, and I'm Mr. Barry. I'm the one who creates all the videos here. If you're new to the channel, please click on Subscribe. And if you like these types of videos, do click on thumbs up, share the video. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to remove an app from your Chromebook. So let's say that you have an app that you want to remove. You can click on the down in the corner. You have this little circle thing there, and that's the app launcher. If you click that, you notice that you do have some apps that are pinned towards the top. What I need you to do is click on the carrot to reveal more apps. There you go. So you have more apps there. And once you have that list, if you right click on them. Now, I made several videos on this in the past, and I found out that 6% of my audience did not know how to do a right click on a Chromebook. And they say, well, where's the right click? I just see a pad down there. Well, if you use two fingers, there, and you press two fingers, like make a peace symbol. And so I'll do that right now. I'll just, let me see. You can't remove Play Store and a lot of these apps because they are part of the Chrome operating system. But let's just say I go down here and I want to take off one of these games or one of these other apps. So here's one, the GIMP, that's for editing images. I right click on it, that is I use two fingers, click, there it is. And it does give me the option to remove it or uninstall it. And so apps can be uninstalled in this way. And if you scroll down, again, that's using two fingers and it's kind of making this type of a motion there on your touchpad. You notice that you have more and more and more apps there. Again, if I want to remove one of these, take the two fingers there, do the right click, and click on uninstall, and it will remove it from your Chrome operating system. Now, the nice thing to know about this too is, let's say you had multiple devices that you're using with one Google account, like I do, then if you do remove an extension or an app from one Chromebook, you go to the next Chromebook, you log into the same account, that app's not going to be there. So it's removed from all of your other devices as well, which is a good thing to know, that you don't have to remove that same app or install the same app multiple times. I'm going to hit escape. When you hit escape, that window goes away and I'm back into my extensions here. You open up a new tab by clicking on the plus there at the top. That's what I've done. And I wanted to talk about some of the other things that we have in here. I get a lot of questions on using Chromebooks. A lot of people are new to Chromebooks. And so let me just show you something here. If I click once there on the three dots, that's called Customize Control Google Chrome. These are options there to control the browser. There are other settings I'm going to show you here in a second. But if you go all the way down to the word settings, click there, and now you're in your Chrome browser settings. Remember, there's a Chrome OS settings. It's in a different location for some reason. But this is the Chrome browser settings. And notice that you do have extensions right here. So you can click on extensions and, you know, get into the same window. So if I was to do that, boom, there it is. There's my extensions again. Let me go back into settings by clicking on the tab at the top. And let's say that you're unfamiliar with the settings and you say, well, you know, I'm unfamiliar with the settings. I really don't know how to do anything with it. So what you can do is you guys could click up there into the search box. And let's say that we wanted to do a safety check. A lot of people, they're kind of concerned about their privacy, about malware, about security and all that. So let's type in the word check. And right away, it gets right there. I'll show you right there. Boom, in the middle of our screen, it says safety check. And you actually can run a safety check on your account and see if there's any data breaches with your data has been, may have been released, such as your name, other information. So just click there and it'll run a check for you. And then it'll actually allow you, show you how to fix those things too. Such as, let's just say that you were, some of your data was involved in a data breach. One thing that I would do is I would change my password. Number two is I would turn on two-step verification. And you can turn on two-step verification there from within your Google settings there. And once you've turned on two-step verification, whenever you try to log in to a device, your phone will ring or give you a message and say, hey, is this you trying to log into your machine? And you simply say, yes, it is me. And you just follow the steps there on your phone. The thing is, if you do get a different phone number in the future, you do want to update your settings so that it has the newest information, the newest phone number. So you can always do the two-step verification there, because it'd be terrible for you to lose your phone and then be out there and needing to log into a new device and not being able to do that because you have two-step verification. So make sure you do update that phone number and always have the current number there. All right, so now you know a little bit about what's called the settings within my Chrome browser. Let's look now for my Chromebook users. And if you look down at the very bottom of the screen here, so I'm going to go away here for a little bit so you can actually see through me. And you click right here and then click into this gear icon. Once you click on the gear icon, you're now into the Chromebook settings. And as you can see, it's different than the other settings. So the first one was the browser settings, and the second one there is the Chromebook settings. And again, it does have a search box at the top. You do have the ability to kind of go to these different categories. A lot of people often ask me, well, how do you check for the latest operating system? Make sure that you have the latest one. Well, right there where it says About Chrome OS, click it, and there you go. You can check there to see that you have the newest one. Right there above me, it says check. Boom, click on the check, and you can actually have it go online, and it will check for the newest version for you and update your operating system so that you have all the features and also security. Speaking of security, a lot of times people want to know, do I need to install another app or an extension for better security on my Chromebook? And I often say, well, no, it's built in. And sure enough, what I found was when I would go to some sites, if that site has been compromised in any way, then what I got was a little red outline for that website, a big flash warning said, warning, do not go here. It's been reported that suspicious software or something suspicious has been going on here. And basically it blocks that site. Now there is a way to route around there and go into advanced settings and, you know, disregard those warnings if you really needed to go in there, knowing full well that that site has been compromised. But still, it does, for the average user, all they see is they see a red warning there and preventing them to go into that site that's been compromised, which is really handy. And that's built into the operating system now. You don't have to install any extra extension or app. Hey, again, if you like these types of videos, make sure you've clicked on that thumbs up. Comment down below because I love to read your comments. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel to get some of the newest videos there on using your Chromebook or just using the Chrome browser, even on a Windows machine. Thank you again, and you have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.